Legal News, 21st May to 27th May 2018 by Deepak Miglani. Son who hits mom cannot claim right to her home, Bombay High Court. The Bombay High Court has observed that a son who ill-treats and assaults his mother cannot claim the right to enter her house. A South Mumbai resident, along with his wife and child, a minor, had approached the court after his 72-year-old mother changed the locks to her Malabar Hill flat and refused him and his family entry. Justice Sharuk Kathawala said that prima facie the son has no right to his mother's home. He also cannot claim any right of entry on grounds of dispossession when the mother is seriously troubled over the problems created by him in the house, including committing assault. New US law attacks India's Russia defense ties. The malign shadow of US sanctions hangs over the informal summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Russia's President Vladimir Putin in Sochi, with New Delhi becoming a cat's paw not only in the scrap between Washington and Moscow but also in turf war between the White House and Congress. Although India has asserted that it will not allow any third country to dictate its ties with Russia, the so-called CARTSA, Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act legislation, has become Washington's poison-tipped arrow, threatening New Delhi's long-cherished and long-nourished defense ties with Moscow, which Washington is trying to whittle down. E-sellers file plea at Competition Commission of India against Flipkart. The All India Online Vendors Association, a body representing more than 3,500 online sellers who sell on e-marketplaces, has filed a petition with the Competition Commission of India against Flipkart, alleging that the e-tailer is favoring its own private brands and select merchants like WS Retail. All India Online Vendors Association has asked the Competition Commission of India to investigate what it calls adverse effects of Flipkart marketplace, which is indulging in unfair and discriminatory practice and offering discounts and predatory pricing through its wholesale arm and some of its own private labels. Supreme Court to SV Global Mill pay small shareholder 100 crore. In upholding the landmark judgment passed by Madras High Court, the Supreme Court has ordered SV Global Mill, which has carved out of 200-year-old textiles major Bini, to pay rupees 100 crore to minority shareholders to buy them out. Delhi High Court clears decks for auction of Taj Man Singh. Delhi High Court dismissed the plea by Tata Group on Indian Hotels Company Limited, challenging the tender procedure for the proposed auction of luxury hotel Taj Man Singh by New Delhi Municipal Council. A bench of Justices S. Ravindra Bhatt and A. K. Chawla said it is apparent that the complex nature of eligibility conditions that NDMC has insisted upon while conceding tenders for the hotel plot are based on thought and deliberation and refuse to intervene in a policy decision. Congress Neta named Sunil Chopra held in HCS judicial paper leak case. The special investigation team looking into Haryana Civil Services judicial paper leak case arrested a Congress leader from Chandigarh, Sunil Chopra, along with another accused, one Ayushi Godara. Chopra is accused of supplying the leaked question paper to some of the candidates. He was also allegedly given the responsibility of getting the contact details of more candidates who may be ready to buy the paper. Chopra has been with the Congress for more than 3 decades and was with the Chandigarh Congress treasurer till last year. Trial court has a duty to ensure availability of diligent and effective defense counsel for accused, Allahabad High Court. While ordering the de novo trial in a murder case, the Allahabad High Court has observed that the trial court has a duty to ensure the availability of a diligent and effective defense counsel for the accused, even when there is a counsel representing him on record, but in fact is only a sham. Central government amends motor accident compensation scale under no-fault liability. The central government has issued a notification to amend the compensation scales for motor accident claims under second schedule of the Motor Vehicles Act 1988 as per the notification issued by Ministry of Road Traffic and Highways on May 22, 2018. The compensation payable in case of death is Rs 5 lakh. In case of permanent disability, the compensation payable is the disability percentage of Rs 5 lakh. The disability percentage is to be calculated as per one schedule of the Workmen's Compensation Act. Justice C.K. Prasad gets second term as Press Council of India Chairman. Former Supreme Court Judge Justice Chandramouli Kumar Prasad has been appointed as the Chairman of the Press Council of India for a second term. The decision was reportedly taken by a three-member committee headed by Vice President Venkatraya Naidu in a meeting held last week. Justice Prasad had taken over from Justice Markande Kadju in November 2014. Mom jailed for forcing girl to marry in Britain. A mother who tricked her teenage daughter into traveling to Pakistan to marry an older man has become the first person in England to be convicted of forced marriage. She was sentenced to 4.5 years in prison. Campaigner said this landmark conviction would send a strong message to families planning to coerce their daughters into marriage. The jury at Birmingham Crown Court heard the girl was betrothed to a man 16 years her senior on a visit to Pakistan when she was 13. The man had sex with her and the girl underwent an abortion on her return to Britain, prosecutor said. When she protested, her mother assaulted her and threatened to burn her passport, the court heard. The girl eventually returned to the United Kingdom with government help. The United Kingdom introduced an offence of forced marriage in 2014, but prosecutions have been rare. Penalty provisions not mandatory. Information seeker cannot resort to penalty proceedings under RTI Act as of right. Chhattisgarh High Court. The High Court said that matter of penalty is between the Commission and erring information officer in which the petitioner information seekers has no right, holding that the penalty provisions under the Right to Information Act is discretionary. The Chhattisgarh High Court has observed that the matter of penalty to be awarded under the Act is between the Information Commission and erring information officer, and the information seeker cannot, as a matter of right, cannot claim audience in the penalty proceedings. Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rules 2016 can be applied irrespective of date of incident, Rajasthan High Court. The Rajasthan High Court recently held that Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Model Rules 2016 can be utilized to determine the age of a child irrespective of the date of occurrence of the offense. The court was hearing a revision petition challenging an order passed by the lower court ruling that appellant was not a juvenile under the Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015. He had submitted that the lower court had relied on his school's register and had ignored the school mark sheet submitted by him for establishing his correct age. Girl with hijab cannot take repeater exam, Bombay High Court. The Bombay High Court declined the plea of a first-year homeopathy student who was allegedly barred from attending college because she wears a hijab to appear for repeater exams from June 6 over poor attendance. Without lectures, how do we allow you? You are studying in medicine, said a bench of Justice Shahrukh Kathawala and Ajay Gadkari. Fakia Badami, a student of Sai Homeopathic Medical College has moved the court after the Maharashtra University of Health Sciences told her college that she does not meet the mandatory attendance criteria. Not mandatory to call two respectable persons for a raid under Immoral Traffic Prevention Act, Rajasthan High Court. The High Court said that it is to be determined by the courts whether it was efficacious for the officers to call two persons from the locality or due to urgency or emergency the said provisions could not be complied with. Mere violation of Section 15, Subsection 2 of the Immoral Traffic Prevention Act will not vitiate the search proceedings, the Rajasthan High Court has held. Section 15, Subsection 2 of the Act stipulates that before making a search without warrant, the special police officer or the trafficking police officer shall call upon two or more respectable inhabitants, at least one of whom shall be a woman of the locality in which place to be searched is situated, to attend and witness the search. Parties summoned by Competition Commission of India Director General have right to be accompanied by advocates but cannot consult them while Director General collects evidence. Delhi High Court. The bench said that the Director General shall ensure that counsel does not sit in front of the witness but is some distance away and the witness should be not able to confer or consult her or him. Though upholding the right of parties summoned by the Director General for investigation under the Competition Act to be accompanied by advocates, the Delhi High Court has directed the Director General to ensure that the counsel does not sit in front of the witness but is some distance away and the witness should be not able to confer or consult her or him. The Competition Commission of India had approached the Division Bench of Delhi High Court against the single bench order that allowed officials of a company summoned by the Competition Commission of India to be accompanied by advocates. IIT moves High Court on metro station naming. IIT Delhi has approached the High Court opposing the naming rights of a metro station near the institute being acquired by a coaching institute. The Premier Engineering College wants Delhi Metro Rail Corporation to either revoke the permission guarantee to Fidji or remove the name of an upcoming metro station at the Safdarjung development area. Liquidated damages for cancellation of contract to attract 18% GST, classifiable as other services, Maharashtra Authority for Advance Ruling. The Maharashtra Authority for Advance Ruling has held that GST is applicable on liquidated damages in case of contracts for operation and maintenance, construction or renovation of power plants entered into by the Maharashtra State Power Generation Company, the applicant in the ruling. The applicant had sought a clarification from the Authority for Advance Ruling as to whether the recovery for liquidated damages from the invoice of the contractor would amount to supply under GST Act. When criminals use modern technologies, court cannot restrain police to counter it. Rajasthan High Court permits taking voice sample of the accused. Directing an accused to give his voice sample, the Rajasthan High Court observed that the police cannot be restrained from taking voice sample of an accused for establishing his involvement in the crime for the reason that there is no provision under the law which permits to take voice sample of the accused during the course of investigation. Registering authority cannot cancel, set aside an already registered sale deed, Allahabad High Court. The full bench of Allahabad High Court in Kusumlata versus State of UP has held a registered sale deed cannot be cancelled or set aside by registering authority or by any authority invoking administrative powers if the registration is questioned even on the count of impersonation and fraud. Please Like the video, share the video, and subscribe the YouTube channel. Thank you.